mobile is hugely important to us at The Guardian, so mobile is our future. Like many publishers, we're seeing a huge transition of our audience onto mobile platforms. So what we see is our apps users consume vastly more content than any other user that we have, actually. Android is clearly a huge part of that.
It's not overstating it to say that our apps users, including our Android users, are most valuable users across the entire portfolio. They read more of our content. They stick around for longer and spend more time with us. App users are between 10 and 20 times more engaged than the average web user. Native apps like our Android app provide features that you can't get on the mobile web. And really this comes down to key things around ever-presence. The fact that once you're on the device, you're always there and you're running, that gives us opportunities that we've never had before. If you look at our Android Wear integration, for instance, then that's really about enabling people to receive Guardian notifications in a much more timely and interesting way, and then to be able to read them straight away or even save them for later if they get a story that they really care about, but they're in a situation where they can't quite read it yet. I'm really proud that the team here have opt-in rate of over 90%, so fewer than 10% of people choose not to get our notifications, and that really speaks to the quality of the editorial choices that we make around them. With such a large audience for our apps, then personalization becomes increasingly important. You can personalize your homepage, and this is a really, really powerful feature. It allows users to select any kind of content from across the entire network. So it could be your favorite subject, it could be your favorite writer, and we want to make sure that the content that's relevant to them is really front and center for their experience.
Having engaged users is critically important. In fact, in many ways, it's more important than just having a large number of users for The Guardian and creating a habit. That's really important to us. So that not only helps us with our monetization, but building that really sort of long lifetime relationship with the audience.
As a business, we passionately believe that the only way to be confident about the products we're going to launch is to test them and test them and test them and get them in front of as many real readers and real users as possible. We do that through Google Play, through replying to reviews. We do that through the Android beta program. Now, the reason we do all of those things, it's because we really want to understand what they're doing with our products, and what they're finding difficult and what they're loving. And that kind of feedback does help us make strategic decisions about what's most important for our readers when they're using the app. A good example is the new search that we're releasing. It's a direct response to feedback we've got both from our beta program and on Google Play as well. Mobile and Android has played a key part in our growth strategy, both in emerging markets and mature markets as well. When we look at our new markets, so India's a really good example, then people there are going straight to mobile, and Android is a large part of that. So our work on Android is part of our international growth.